ASUG 2018 Bhubaneswar. I am Dr. Shahu Ingole and you are watching me live on Emcure AICOG TV. I am glad to have with me the eminent personality, Dr. Hemant Deshpande sir from Pune. Sir is the professor and head department of obstetric and gynecology, Dr. D.Y. Patil Medical College, Pune. So welcome to the show, sir.
Thank you, sir.
So sir, in relation to your recent talk in ASUG 2018, we all know that the burden of anemia is increasing globally as well as in India. So in relation to that, how common anemia is as far as the twin pregnancy is concerned?
If you see the incidence of the anemia in twin pregnancy, it is practically 80%, because twins are much more prone for having anemia in antenatal period, and it is reasonably earlier than the singleton pregnancy. The twin pregnancy, the hemodilution, that's much more than the singleton pregnancy. The plasma volume, that is increased practically up to 65%, which is in single pregnancy up to 50%. And the RBC volume increase will remain same, that is 17 to 25%. Hence the hemodilution in multiple pregnancy or twin pregnancy is much more. And these people, they are having physiological anemia. The needs of the mother, the needs of the twin, and obviously the dietary factors, the absorption factors, and many more things that make the patient to develop the anemia in the second trimester onward, along with the exaggerated physiological anemia in pregnancy. So she is a patient who needs to be supplemented a right time, right iron. That's what I can say. A right iron, right time, and right dose. If these three things are there, we can tackle the anemia in multiple pregnancy. The dose of the iron requirement in twin pregnancy has to be increased. It's a, she has to have the supply to the twins, two babies. So automatically, the maternal need, the need of the placenta, the need of the twin pregnancy, that makes increase in supplementation of elemental iron. Usually we give around 60 milligram of the elemental iron in a singleton pregnancy. Here we have to give approximately 100 milligrams of the elemental iron, and that to tackle the physiological anemia. And if she develops anemia more than that, automatically we have to give a more iron, more folic acid supplementation, practically 5 milligram per day to this lady, and protein supplementation has to be made practically doubled up. The weight gain in this particular patient is not 9 or 10 kg, it is 15 to 16 kg, 1.5 times more. So automatically all needs of the patient, they increase. Her caloric requirement, they increase by 300 kilocalories. Normally we advise the patient to take 2500. Here we have to ask the patient to take something like 2800 kilocalories. And these are the people, if they have anemia, they have lot of complications. Twins per se responsible for many problems. More spontaneous abortions, more incidence of preeclampsia, more incidence of preterm labor, more incidence of premature rupture of membranes, more incidence of placenta previa. So all these problems which they are there, they will be exaggerated if the patient is having superadded anemia. So if you keep the hemoglobin of a multiple gestation patient more than 11 grams, normally for a singleton pregnancy I say more than 10 grams, yes, it's okay. But here it has to be more than 11 grams if you avoid a preterm labor, to avoid the premature rupture of membranes, to avoid the small birth weights of the baby. Let's make the twin pregnancy by supplying a right iron at right time in right dose, along with the protein and folic acid, so that you can carry the twin pregnancy up to term very safely. I always say ek se bhale do, and that is really true when two babies are there in the uterus, when we are taking their proper care.
So sir, to reduce the burden of anemia and thereby to reduce the morbidity and mortality, what will be your key message for the practitioners when it comes to the twin pregnancy?
Investigations to be done in a right time. Hemoglobin has to be done in the first trimester. Do it every 4 weekly, so that you can come to know that when the patient is going to develop the anemia. For a normal pregnancy, 3 times hemoglobin is sufficient. Here I advise, let the hemoglobin should be done every monthly interval, so that you can come to know minimum hemoglobin, PCV, and peripheral blood smear. you come to know the anemia as early as possible, detect early, treat early and avoid the complication. Twin pregnancy is a good pregnancy provided we are taking good care of the patient.
So thank you so much, sir, for the informative discussion and throwing the light on the management of the twin pregnancy and the role of iron and folic acid in reducing the burden of anemia.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr.